Good morning, viewers. This video presentation is about pharmaceutical companies which have given more than 70% returns, between 70 to 80%. Already we have seen the stocks which have given more than 300% stocks, which are Arthi Drug, Lawrence Lab, Quopron, IOL Chemicals, and a drug pharma. These four companies have given more than 300% return year after year to investors. Then the next video is Granules India, SMS Pharma, Solar Active Pharma, NGL Fine Chemicals, Nalar Laboratory. These five companies have given return between more than 150% and less than 200%. And then the third video is Strix Pharma, Sequence Scientific, JB Chemicals, SMS Life Science, Wockhardt, Divi's Lab, Bajaj Healthcare. These companies have given more than 100% and less than 150%. Next video uploaded is Advanced Enzyme, Mercury Laboratory, Arbinda Pharma, Freedom Pharma, IPCA Laboratories. These five companies have given more than 90% and less than 100% return during last 1 year, year after year. The next video we have uploaded today is Panacea Biotech, Cadila Healthcare, Alembic, Dr. Reddy Lab, Alembic Pharmaceuticals. These five companies have given the returns between 80 to 90%. Now, in this video, we will see three companies which have given return to investors between 70 to 75%. These three companies. First company, Ajanta Pharma, which has given 75% return to investors. Next company, AstraZeneca Pharma, 72%. Cipla, 72%. These three companies have given 74%, 72%, 72% respectively. Now, we may see the other details of the company. The first company, we may go to the see the first company. We will see the market data, shareholding pattern, and the latest quarterly results only quickly and easily for you. Okay. Now, the Ajanta Pharma, today closing price is 1651 and the 52 week high is 1760, 52 weeks low is 950 rupees. Please note, face value of the company is 2. And A group company. Now we may see the shareholding pattern of the concern. The shareholding, promoter holding is 70.51. Mutual fund holding is 9.93. FII holding 7.71. Balance 9.59, nearly less than 10% is held by public. Remaining 90% is held by high net worth investors. Please note. And we may see the latest quarterly results. Please wait. Please wait, we may see the latest quarterly results. The company, the quarter ended 30th September 2020. The total income current quarter is 720.78 crores as against 655.98 crores in the year of year quarter 30th September 19. A good increase, nearly 10%. Top line growth is 10%. And a net profit for the period is 170.22 crores as against 116.36 crores, nearly 50% up. IPCA Laboratory, Ajanta Pharmaceutical has delivered a good results. And the EPS side, That last quarter EPS is 19.51 as against 13.34, nearly 50% increase. And also please note, the paid up capital of the company is 17.54 crores. And also please note, the face value of the company is 2. So anyhow, Ajanta Pharma is a good future oriented pharmaceutical concern. You may consider for investment in the year 21. Next, we may go to AstraZeneca. AstraZeneca Pharma, the today closing price is 4,603, 52 weeks high 4,970, 52 weeks low 1,888, and face value of the company is, please note, 2. Pharmaceutical company, high PE ratio. Now, we may see the shareholding pattern of the company. The promoter holding is 75%. Mutual fund 2.22. Non-institution holding 20.69. That is a public holding. Balance 80% is held by high net worth investors. And also, please note, the equity of the company is very low. A small cap company, just 5 crores. Face value is 2. Now, we may see the quarterly results, latest quarterly results of that concern. Please wait. The September quarter, we may see. The latest quarter, 3 months ended, the total income is 214.19 crores as against 211.64 crores. Top line growth, not so much, just 1% only. Just 1% only. The profit, net profit after tax, 26.33 crores as against 14.41 crores. Nearly bottom line is nearly 50% growth. Even though top line growth is not so much, but the bottom line is nearly 50%. Similarly, on EPS side, the latest quarter EPS is 10.54 as against 5.77 in the year of year first quarter. Anyhow, AstraZeneca, even though it has not declared a good top line growth, but considering the bottom line growth, you may consider for investment in the year 2021. Then, finally, the third company, Cipla Limited, we may see. The latest price, Cipla, is 826, 52 week high 838, 52 week low 356. Face value of the company is 2. BSE 100 Sensex, A group company. Then we may see the shareholding pattern. The promoter holding is 36.70. Mutual fund holding is 16.58. FII holding is 20.06. Insurance holding 2.76. Public holding is only 23.48. Remaining 77% is held by high net worth investors. And also please note, the promoter fledged holding details is 0. That is also a positive factor. The equity of the company is 161.27. Already we have told face value 2. The equity is very high. Okay, now we may see the latest quarterly results of Cipla Limited. Please wait. Now, the latest results, total income in the quarter 39-2020 is 5,091.76 crores as against 4,496.30 crores. A good increase. Nearly top line growth is 10%. Similarly, the net profit for the period is 665.43 crores as against 475.735 crores. This also a good increase. So Cipla company has declared a good increase both in top line as well as in bottom line. And on the EPS side, the basic EPS latest quarter is 8.25 as against 5.85. So you may consider for investment on dips, the Cipla company you may include in your portfolio and buy on every corrections and hold for 1 year. You may expect a moderate return. So we have so far seen Ajanta Pharma, AstraZeneca Pharma, Cipla, all these three companies have given a good bottom line and a top line growth, except AstraZeneca, which has given just 1-2% top line. But other Ajanta Pharma and Cipla have given a good results both in top line as well as in bottom line. But AstraZeneca have given a bottom line growth. So considering all these factors, and also all companies have not pledged their shares to any financials, that will also be a good factor and a good growth oriented company. Even though already the company has given more than 70-80% return in 1 year return, but in this year you may expect a moderate return, 15-20%, if you could be able to buy on every corrections, you may expect a moderate return, 15-20% in the year 21-22 financial years. Okay, thanking you for viewing this video. If you like this video, please subscribe, comment and share with your friends.